Hello, and welcome to this video tutorial. In this video, we're going to present an overview of the Reservations module by taking a look at the Availability, Rate Quote, and the Room Chart screens. As you can see, when the mouse is hovered over these subjects, the mouse pointer turns into a hand, indicating that this is a hyperlink. Let's start with the Availability screen. The Availability screen opens by default with the current business day and provides 14 days of availability. There are two columns under each date, one column representing rooms sold, and the other column representing the remaining availability. Moving up to the top of the screen, these arrows will move the date forward or backwards one day per click. After clicking on the arrow, you'll need to click on the Check Availability button again for the screen to update. The other option is to use the calendar. Let's change the date to July 4th. As you can see, the availability grid now starts with July 4. The system also displays any booking rules that are in effect for this time period. As you can see, we have a 3-night restriction set for any reservations arriving on the night of July 4th. Now let's take a look at the Rate Quote screen. Notice that if we change the number of nights, the system automatically updates the departure date. Anytime a change is made to the guest stay information, click on View Rates to refresh the screen. In these columns, the system displays an average rate per night, a total room charge for the entire stay, estimated taxes for the stay, and an estimated total cost. The Room Available column shows how many of each room type are available for the length of the guest stay. If the hotel was sold out of a room type on any of the dates of the guest stay, the rooms available would show as zero. Notice these two hyperlinks available, Walk-in and Reservation. Simply click to continue the reservations process or walk in a guest. We'd like to also point out two other areas, Rate Code and Group. Using the drop-down beside Rate Code, we can quickly select another rate, such as Senior. Remember, each change on this screen requires that we click on View Rates again. If a caller was inquiring about a group block that was established, then select the group from the drop-down box. Notice in the Rooms Available column that only three room types available have reserve links beside them. That's because these are the only three room types in this group's block. The last area that we'll take a look at is the Room Chart screen. The Room Chart gives us a look at each room, who's checked into or pre-blocked for that room. As you can see, guests are identified by color code depending on the status of their reservation. Double-clicking on a guest will drill into their reservation. Notice that the room numbers are also color-coded to let you know what the housekeeping status for each room is. It's very important to remember that this screen does not represent overall hotel availability because it only reflects registered guests and reservations that have been pre-assigned to a room. Thank you for taking the time to view this video. Please feel free to contact your account manager or our customer support center for additional questions.